Janey Stahl. It's nice to meet you all. And I founded Janey Stahl Coaching early this year, just 2 months ago. So I'm going to give you a little bit of my background and how this business came to be. So like most teenagers, I did not know what to major in, and I actually went with my head instead of my heart. It's 2009, a lot of my friends weren't able to get jobs, so I'm like, I'm going to do finance, I'm guaranteed a job with that. Landed a really good job, however, I was working a lot of hours, it was very stressful, and I just had this nagging feeling that this isn't what I'm meant to do. I couldn't put my finger on what exactly that was, but I just knew this isn't it. Then I had a baby, and I had a 1 hour commute one way, would get home late at night, wasn't spending any time with my baby, so I'm like, I need to make a change. So one common thread that I've always had in my life is I like to help people, and I'm a very driven person, and I really strive to be a better person each and every day. So I wanted to help people do the same thing. So I became a personal development coach and launched this business. Let me back up for a second. I actually got the courage to leave my corporate job. A friend of mine started his own company. And so we've been doing that for about a year now, and that gave me the courage to, you know what, I think I can do this own thing and start my own business. So I'm operating under the broad umbrella of a personal development coach, because for me, personal development is different for everybody. So maybe you want to become an entrepreneur and start your own business. Maybe you want to climb the ladder and get a promotion. Personal development goals and professional development goals can intertwine, and we all have different goals. Maybe you just want to be a better spouse or parent. So organizational development as well is a little different, where you're helping employees, managers, teams work together and function better within an organization. However, that still comes down to the individual employee or manager. They have to want to be a better person in order to improve the organization. So the process that I like to follow is, first you need to uncover your own talents, strengths, weaknesses, what are your dreams, what is your purpose, and then develop your weaknesses, improve those, determine your goals and what your next steps are going to be, then you can take action, and then hopefully get to a place where you are in flow or you feel like you are doing what you're meant to do. Another key differentiation I'd like to make is, a consultant tells clients what to do. A coach helps clients reach their own solution. So I am branding myself as a personal development coach. I have three key pillars of services. One is coaching, the second are workshops or courses, and the third are keynotes. Because personal development is different for each person, these services apply to a broad array of audiences, such as students. What's their problem? They're trying to figure out what they want to do, the solution. I can help them with their resume, with their job search, coach them. People that are in the workforce who feel like this isn't what they're meant to do, entrepreneurs who want to start their own business, or even companies who don't have the time and resources to develop their employees. What I've found is the solution and the result is the same for all. So my services, coaching, courses, keynotes, would help them maximize their potential so that they can achieve their dreams. So along with those three key services, one area, my ultimate goal is to have passive income, aka move into the online course space. So what I've done to set that up is I have my website, I have opt-ins to grow my email list so that I can reach out to those people later on to say, hey, this course is available. I've done my market research. I found that there's actually a gap. A lot of companies are aligned with an organizational development consultant, so that person would come in, speak to the entire company about how to be a better manager, how to work together better within their teams. However, what I found when I was in the corporate world was I didn't have the time. I couldn't get the PTO to go to these workshops or these keynotes or go listen to an organizational development consultant. So what I feel like would be convenient for the employees and also help the companies who are trying to provide this resource for their employees is if there was a 1 hour course that somebody could take at any time of the day, that would be much more convenient. It's a win-win for the employee and the company. And it could be too that the course is much broader than their career goals. So I want to offer a wide array of topics and courses. So I'm hoping to build my curriculum within the next month, start to invest in a platform for that, and then partner with companies who are willing to offer these courses to their employees. So what's going well right now? I've done some pop-up workshops or courses. They've been live in-person group coaching. Those went really well. I got a lot of good feedback and positive testimonies. My engagement rate is really good. This is just a sample of my opt-ins. So I've been running my opt-ins for about 1 month now, where I'm trying to get the email addresses. And I have a really good engagement rate with that. I also have a few keynotes lined up for the rest of the year. Where I'm struggling and where I need your guys' help is, so I'm juggling two jobs, essentially. I'm impatient and I just feel like my email list is growing slowly. It's hard to get my name out there and network with companies and network with people when I have a daytime job. And then also the course platform to host the online courses is fairly expensive. I haven't invested a ton of money in this. I really want to be able to bring in revenue to offset my expenses. So my questions for you are, should I narrow my niche? Do I seem too scattered? How can I get my name out there and grow my audience faster? Should I take the leap of faith and I haven't invested in like Facebook ads or Google ads? Should I invest in this course, this online course platform? And then just if you have any other suggestions or tips for me. So what do I need? Again, I'll come back to word of mouth, referrals, and then if you have any suggestions or advice. So thank you for your time. Workshops, I'm doing $100 an hour for the courses. The keynotes, I'm doing $400 an hour with the idea that if you get four more people within a company, that's going to be more affordable than the individual workshops or courses. My coaching, I'm doing $120 an hour. I'm also offering to work on your resume and give you feedback and help you. I'll set up a template for that. I'm doing $80. And then a job search package. This job search package is $300. So I do have photos and videos, and then I have testimonies from the pop-up workshops that I did. And I need to add the videos to my website. And then I also plan on, when I go to launch other events or courses, I plan to include that video within the email and then on the event itself. I also, I don't know if I already said this, I have some testimonies on my website as well. But do you have other suggestions?
I feel like I follow like Instagram is like the location where everyone like puts stuff up there right now. People I follow in the wellness and health and all that kind of stuff, coaching industries. And it seems like they either have live video features of certain clients that are really kind of like benefiting from them, those courses, or stories or kind of clips of that to kind of help market it that make you think about why that person is saying that about the coach.
Okay.
From it. So I don't know how you're using Instagram, but the clips of that or kind of editing those things. Yeah,
okay.
You're really intriguing, maybe.
I'm curious. I feel like people do not want to be videotaped. So how do you get around that?
Have you asked people?
Yeah.
I'd love
like
to open to
that.
People
want to be videotaped if you, they're just, I mean, you should ask them that. Like, if they feel
okay.
Like they're benefiting from you. I mean, if I was in one of your clients' position, I would want to help support them because I felt value from you.
Yeah.
And also them getting, like, a platform.
Yeah,
be.
True. Okay.
Doesn't hurt to ask.
Yeah.
I would say.
Yeah, I need to just fuck up.
Yeah. Ask. They can say no and you can be cool about it. But
okay.
For those few that you do that say yes, no, it'll be really helpful.
Yeah, Andre, do you?
What's
struggled. I feel like I relate more with women, especially the whole, like, the reason I tell that story on my website is to make a connection, right? You're either, you don't really know what you're meant to do, you're in an unfulfilling job, or the whole parenthood struggle. I feel like a lot of people struggle with the stress and the work-life balance. So I feel like I connect more with women. However, this is just coming from my other business. I feel like a lot of business owners and men are more willing to invest in things like this. And I also have a mastermind, and it's just really hard to get moms, women to commit the time to things like this. That's very candid. And so, yeah, so I'm going after both men and women. But
with the focus of women.
Yeah.
I think it's okay to say, hey, look, my business is geared towards young, professional, entrepreneurial women, because I think there's a void in the ecosystem for the entrepreneurial women. I think there's not enough women that's pursuing business opportunities. And I think it's wide open for them to do that. There's just, you know, most women
So email lists can take a long time to grow, right? Like, they're the gold standard, but they can take a long time to grow. So I'm curious, have you thought about doing a Facebook private group around personal development where you could get a bunch of people in there, give them content, and help that become the pool once people know I can trust you?
Yeah, that's a good idea. So here's what I'm debating with that is I feel like there are so many Facebook communities, and I personally get overwhelmed with them. So I wanted to create like a subscription where you get access to the private Facebook community. I don't know, like on one hand it'd be a good way to build your audience and your community, but then...
And you can get clients out of there, you know, once you kind of have that built, and if you really nurture that community and space to have the people who really like you. And then once you're doing your courses, having a pool, maybe they don't want to, they can't afford to work with you privately, but they could go through a course, you could test out some of that content with those people.
I think that is a good point, because that's how I've gotten started, is I'm not willing to invest in a relationship like this right away, and so if they offer free advice or community like that, and I get to know them, it does help build the relationship, so that's a good idea. Thank you.
And it can build faster than, a lot faster than email.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah.
And private Facebook groups are a really good option for you, especially since it's low cost, but it really offers a great way to have an interactive experience away from that's not in person preview for clients. I work with a group that does business coaching. It's women focused.
Okay.
And they did, they had videos in their Facebook group that, you know, everyone had subscribed. It was a subscription model, like you're talking about.
Okay.
They'd be in the group. They would, you know, watch the video and interact in the comments. The coaches would be in there. They did a live webcast where people could either come to the thing in person, or they could log on and pay to watch the webcast and interact that way, so I think that could be a really good option for you to start.
Okay. So, yeah, with that, the thing I don't really like about the live videos is I want it to be in person, and I don't like having to answer questions, you know what I mean, the, like, comments that come up. So they did it, it was, you could either be in person, but then they also videotaped it so that people could go back and watch it?
Yeah, so it was, they did a live conference, you know, in person, and then they also had an option for people that couldn't come to pay to log on and watch and sort of get the experience. So multiple things.
Okay, cool.
And depending on the type of group, you can do a Facebook premiere, so it shows up like a live video, but it's pre-recorded, and then you can be there and answer questions, so it can be a little bit easier than you trying to do both the answering and the talking.
Yeah.
Right, like you can record a segment, and then you can upload it as if it were a live video. It shows up like live the very first time you premiere it, and then you can interact with people that come on to the premiere.
Okay, got it.
And also, I think that's a really great step before you double down on an online platform, an online course content. That really is time intensive to develop and expensive, and you don't know if you have a market for it yet.
Right.
And so for me, it seems like a really good longer term vision, but something like what's being proposed is an easier way to sort of build the audience a little bit.
Okay.
Also to test out some of your content. What, you know, like
So what I found is there are a lot of organizational development consultants. So people that are going into companies already have that foot in the door. However, two I've spoken with. One gal is retiring and kind of offered to, she's not looking to take on any new clients, so she's offered to collaborate with me on that. However, what I found is she said that she would rather go spend her time and travel and go into companies. So I feel like I said, there's a gap in the market there where it's more time effective. I can be more profitable if I can offer online courses to multiple people at any time of the day. So organizational consultants. Another area that I've really found is the whole like online business, like I can help you generate this passive income. I feel like there are so many people who say they are a business coach and are pitching exactly that, trying to help people get their online business going. And there are a lot of prominent people in that space that I feel like I can't compete with. So that's kind of one area, one reason why I don't want to focus on just that niche.
Do you have any certifications or, are you a strengths finder coach? Do you do any of that personal development specification that you can put on your resume or say, I can offer this in addition to my coaching services?
So I do not have any certifications. Reason being because I have my master's degree and we kind of covered a lot of that. I feel like with my career background, I've worked in corporate finance, I understand how to build a business. I've done marketing, I've done psychology, human resources. So I kind of have also the mindset side. Again, I'll come back to the gal who is retiring. She said that she doesn't have any certifications, and she's like, I was able to grow my business fine. So some people say that, yes, they would want somebody who is certified. Other people say no. I don't know. What's your guys' take on that?
I think that it's okay that you don't have certifications, but in your presentation, you didn't tell me why you are the right choice for me to come to you as a coach.
Okay.
And saying that you have this background in this corporate environment and you know that you are familiar with psychology, I think that kind of thing is really strong.
Okay.
You should add that.
Okay, thank you.
Additionally, that helps to sort of refine not only what you're offering, but it will maybe help tailor, like,
who's a good fit
for you by going through that. So I think for that, it can be really helpful to offer your service.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So I'd also be interested in, as you get sort of a client that you've had more long-term, getting testimonials from that sort of person. Because I assume that's sort of your ideal customer, someone who's going to have, instead of just, they went to one event. Those are probably going to be the testimonials that I think would hold a little more weight. Saying, yes, this person started with me at this point, then a year later, these are all the things that, I felt like, I got from the experience.
Okay, so let me throw this question out to the group. So what the debate I'm having is, do I invest my time and resources in having like a broad platform where I have one-on-one coaching with clients, and the online courses to have like a diverse mix of services, or do I just focus on the online courses and really pursue that?
You do both.
Okay.
Online is, it's passive income. We spoke about that this morning.
Yep.
It's an opportunity to make money while you're sleeping, which is the American dream, right?
Yeah.
And then the face-to-face allows you to bring emotion, because there's no better way to connect with people than to be in front of them. Like, even text messages don't work, FaceTime, all that stuff. It's very technology, but having one-on-one, having someone see you in 3D, I think there's no better opportunity to gain the trust of a person by physically,
it's going to be hard to not, if you're just doing the courses and you aren't getting the immediate feedback, I think you're going to struggle, because you don't know everything right now.
Right.
So you really sort of need real people to sort of experiment with.
Okay.
And sort of grow.
Okay.
And I was going to say, see what you spend 80% of your time, things that come up over and over and over again that you coach your clients on.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are your tips, your gold wisdom, the nuggets, and then create the course from that rather than doing it the other way, right? Like, seeing, I've worked with 100 people, 80% of the time, these are the things that come up. Use that as, like, how you build your course, because then you have that tested and the things that work, the strategies that you've used over and over again with people.
Okay.
I think an interesting strategy for you, too, or at least one of your strategies, could be aligning yourself with complementary influencers, whether it's in the community in person here. There might be, like, certain groups that you can attend and offer some kind of, like, coaching discount for, or maybe there's already a health coach that you can align yourself on a professional, personal level with, so that you can complementarily, like, refer to each other. But also, the clients that one person might have are already interested in self-development and taking courses, and they might want to continue that. So that could be a really good way to gain support from other people, but already finding groups of people that are wanting to improve themselves.
Yeah, that makes sense.
There's a common theme that's going through here. I don't know if you've picked up on it yet, but this dovetails very well into what certifications do you have? What organizations do you belong to? And that is a question I want you to answer. What organizations do you belong to, both locally or anything on a national level? Because they do have conventions and things of that nature. The reason I'm saying all this is because it all comes down to credibility. Belonging to an organization, having a certification, having people that will endorse you, having things on your website that says, I did such and such a program for such and such a company for this many people with this kind of results.
Yeah.
All that is credibility. It's all building your credibility and trust.
Yeah. So a lot of my communities and involvement was associated, tied back to my corporation, but I'm involved with SHRM, the human resources.
So those are things you can put on your website.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. And then
if you don't say that, nobody's going to say it for you.
Yeah.
Can you describe some of the email campaigns that you've done to, like, gather some of those email addresses?
Yeah, I should provide a snapshot, but so what I've been doing is they're all on my website, so I'm not running any ads to them.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go to my website, one will pop up that's for, like, a mindfulness journal. For each blog post, I try to create a download, like a guide or something that relates to that blog post. So one of my most popular ones is how to start a business with no money and what are your most affordable resources. I think that's just because I'm involved in other communities where we're all starting online businesses. So that's where I'm kind of struggling. It's hard to find other people outside of that niche. Other ones are like a one-on-one template for managers and employees. Another one is like another daily journal prompt, something that you can fill out. So those are just a few examples. Do you have suggestions?
No, I think those are all great. But you said you're not doing like ads with them, like on Facebook, kind of.
I haven't.
Because I think that's a great way to gather interest. I know I'm a sucker for those things. Like, I see, like, top 10 ways to, like, improve your life, and I click it, and it's like, oh, enter your email. I'm like, whatever, I'll do it.
Yeah.
So I feel like that might be, even a small investment will go far with that, just being able to target the people on Facebook that will be interested in.
Yeah. My goal was, so I want to have a complete funnel. So, yeah, you offer your freebie, but then I want to be able to offer, like, the end product.
Mm-hmm.
And I kept thinking, like, well, I need to have the online course to then draw them to that in the next step. But I think I'm just going to offer the coaching and offer some other services.
Yeah. I think you're good just to start now and gather that interest. And then, you know, once you have that offer, you can offer it. But I think, you know, just doing your existing is fine.
Thanks. Yeah.
Yeah, so we went through some of the market segments that we need to address, but have you thought about
I feel like I identify with and connect with women, but then too, I have this reverse psychology of like, I'm not going to be a better person if I don't diversify and surround myself with different people to open up my mind. And
right. I just, you know, if you're asking if you should narrow your niche, mm-hmm. then you probably should a little, you know, because like you're saying, you're juggling two jobs, you don't have a lot of resources. What you do have is the time that you're giving to your clients. And if you can really nail, you know, like one type of client, you'll get, you know, it sort of builds on itself and allows you to get better at helping that, you know, one certain type of person.
Yeah.
I think, you know, instead of trying to boil the ocean and help everybody, if you're just one person,
right.
you know, you might want to try to focus in on what you understand best.
Yeah. And I think, too, I've struggled with what part of my story should I share if I go after the people who are wanting to start their own business and also are juggling multiple jobs, then that resonates with them. But then too, I don't want to come off as like, I'm not committed, and well, why would I hire you if you're not committed to this business full time? Yeah.
No, I was just saying, tying off of that, you know, even narrowing down further from saying you know, you can connect better, you can connect with women, but even within that, it's probably a particular type of woman.
Yeah.
And going to that, so you can also say, if you take the time to sort of really think through what are the attributes, what are the things that are going on with that type of person that you connect with, you might even see like there's crossover into different audiences. It may or may not be just women, it might be people who, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
And so just narrowing a little bit that way, it doesn't necessarily need to be like a category, but it's really trying to figure out like who's, what are the personas
yeah.
of people that would be really good fit clients for you.
So for, I tried, oops. Okay, so my tagline is helping driven individuals
yeah.
because I found that, I mean, as a coach, you need to be empathetic and all that, but I'm a very driven person, and so when somebody's got like excuse after excuse, I'm like, this is not working out. So I've identified that at least, that it's somebody who is a go-getter, who really wants to make themselves a better person. I don't know, do I need to be even more specific? Yeah, okay.
And thinking about like, be a better person, what does that mean?
Yeah.
Is that something to you? Is that something to them? And just sort of
yeah.
really keep going back and asking yourself like, why that? Multiple times, and that can get you some crystallization for who you might be looking for.
Right.
Okay.
And going right along with that, I think you know, both of the people who are younger and they also know what they want to do, as well as people who are professionals and are in the status of what they're doing. And I think that a lot of those people completely different places. So that's a specification where you might want to choose one over the other, as well as what you were mentioning about helping people who want to go to be, you know, more entrepreneurial or self-employed, and maybe that's another, you know,
yeah.
kind of niche specification.
Yeah.
Do you want to take that on or not?
Right. Okay.
And it's not to say that you can't do multiple of those at some point, but where do you start so that you can
yeah.
generate some clients out?
On your list of challenges, you had something about the course platform is expensive. I'm wondering what that is that you're pursuing and what are the features of it that are attractive to you, and maybe this group might have suggestions and alternatives.
Yeah, so I was looking into Kajabi because I can have my website on there. You can do your set up your payment with it. You can schedule the class offer. You can have like a drop down with multiple times and dates. You can do your leads through that. It just seemed like you got the most bang for your buck. If anybody has other tools that they recommend, I'm all ears.
Where's your website currently?
With Squarespace.
So you said you people schedule times to take those courses, or is it just like a library of videos that I can like take one after another after another?
Well, okay, so I wanted to do like my free series. I was gonna do like 3 webinars that were pre-recorded and they could watch on their own time. But then for my online courses, it would be, I would also like to have it pre-recorded, but they would be able to select the date and time, and it's just one course.
that's just me personally. I don't know, other people might have different opinions on that.
Yeah, that's a good, I guess I've just only seen it where I'm clicking on the lead, the ad, to a specific course. And I haven't really seen it where they offer all of them, but I could do that.
Any thoughts from the crowd on that?
Sometimes compliance can drop if it's like all at once. It's like too much binging versus like having stuff dripped out.
Yeah. Say that again?
Like if you have like a whole bunch and that people can get overwhelmed. So I've seen it both ways. Because I've had courses that do like a library of stuff that's released all at once and then some stuff that's dripped out over time. So maybe you could do a combo approach. Sometimes it can be overwhelming to get like 50 hours of content that you have to go through versus like a little bit at a time.
Yeah, that makes me kind of feel like I'm doing like continuing education or something like that. Like that.
You're just like next.
Yeah, like okay. I'd rather have like a more like interactive, personally type of thing.
Yeah.
Because I'm just like, depending on your like schedule, like I'm like I need flexibility. Like, but if you can just have like one week when you can watch it whenever during that week, then I'd be fine with it. But I don't want like at 7 o'clock on Tuesday night. Have to log in and do your class.
Yeah. Sorry, like, it's open up on Monday and you have until next Monday to, you know, then the next one gets released.
Okay. Yeah.
If there are no further questions from the audience, I'll ask the final question. What can we do as an entrepreneurial community to help you?
If you want to connect with me, I have my business cards. And if you are interested or know of anybody else who might be interested, just word of mouth.
Okay.
So thank you so much.
Thank you.